Wala naman, ano, something like, walang benchmark at that time. Yung sa'yo, walang gumagawa yan sa'yo, even all of these things. Ano, did you guys benchmark from somewhere? Did you copy it in the States or abroad? Where did you get the idea of doing that?
For me at that time, I was working for a magazine called World Executive Digest, and it was an international management magazine. And one of the things that I was tasked to do there was to put together seminars and sell books through wala pang internet noon eh. So
mano-mano.
I'm sorry, that's radio eh.
Hindi man lang dial up eh, no? Wala pang internet.
You know, when I started our business, I was one of the first to have an email address.
Wow.
And the email was sent by a dial-up, if you remember that. And you wait for it, yeah. But then the benchmark then was really, my benchmark was Hollywood.
Wow.
No, so, what Hollywood in a sense, no, because low startup, if you notice how Hollywood producers run their businesses, it's very, most of them run it from their house. Then they put a project together, then they get the best people available, the best actors that they can find, directors, etc. Put them together in a group, launch out the project, get funding, and then after the project happens, they all disband. So when I was starting my business, it was home-based, I thought of putting together an event, so I thought of getting the best people available for that time, and pay them up for a project basis. And then once the project or business was over, disband again. So I only had two regular employees when I was starting. So, and that business model actually is not original. That's being taught by Tom Peters.
Oh, okay.
The new business model that he suggests.
How about you, ma'am? May meron kang benchmarkan or was it really?
Opo, sa akin po wala po talaga. Yung nakita ko lang sa dyan, opo.
That's a very unique, you know? It's a very unique. I don't even see that in other places.
Pero ngayon po, sir, bali nagiging booming na po yung industry, yung recreation activity ng mga bata. Okay. So, nagkakaroon na rin po.
Alright. Ikaw pala nag-set mo kayo. How about you, RJ?
Sa Mercato kasi, the inspiration actually namin is that, well, the first thing that you do, when the more technical way to set up the business would have been to do extensive research, di ba? Yan yung bias ko lang because I used to work for a brand manager, I was a brand manager before. Pero wala na kayong mga heavy financial resources ng isang multinational para sumaliksik. So wala na. I didn't have that one. But then, what's very important as an entrepreneur, and what I always see is that you have to have very good observational skills and seeing how you can apply that to business. So what happened lang was that me and my wife, we, like many Filipinos, we enjoy traveling. At napansin namin, when you go abroad, sa Asia, maraming mga night food markets. If you go to Taiwan, there's Shimin. If you go to Thailand, there is Chapuchak, there's Patpong. If you go to Hong Kong, and if you go to Singapore, there's a street that they closed down, di ba, that where not kayo kumakain. So, bakit sa lahat ng mga bansa sa Asia, more or less, there's always a night food market na naging tourist or foodie destination. Pero sa Pilipinas, wala tayong equivalent ng ganyan. So nakita namin dyan, so we said, there must be some sort of opportunity. So the second thing also, in terms of looking outside, nakita rin namin, okay, let's look outside right now. The trend has been changing. It might not have worked before a couple of years ago, but now there's the growing business process outsourcing market, which is more at night, di ba? At the same time, aside from that, then open at night, you also know that marami tindahan na nagsasara by 10 o'clock. Diba? So there's a large segment that is being underserved at that time. So we said, okay, that those are good. And of course, nakita rin namin, they were also the model of Pancetto, which is working very well in a call center area. So sabi namin, this looks like it would work. But our project was being done in Bonifacio Global City. So we were saying, let's see if we can do a night food market. Take what we saw from somebody else's model and improve on it. Yeah. So we said, well, maybe we can curate. Let's curate.
So, RJ, you recommend this is meant to benchmark.
Yeah, more or less benchmark, and then you have to compete against yourself. Eh? In other words, you go, okay, we can. If they're doing this, then what can we do a bit better? So that's when we put up the business, and then that's when we knew them. Kumbaga, we don't have the data, but more or less, sometimes over the years we just develop more of an instinct. Eh? Somebody, parang ito, you have the feel for it, and they said, you know, that's when we launched the business, and thankfully it worked. And the last and most important thing, that we realized the target market na meron kami, if you're going for a younger age group nowadays, is that they're all very, very technologically savvy. They either have an email account, a Facebook account, a Twitter account, and an Instagram account. If they have all that one, and you are very good at getting towards that market, you might be able to get them to come. And so that's what we were able to establish from the market. So they call it external assessment, and then looking at, you know, that's what I very important I want to stress when you are an entrepreneur is, you know, there's not a day that my wife is doing the massive entrepreneurship. Every day, her training is to always look around and say, what's the new opportunity here? What's the new, everything that she does, whether or not it works or not, she just throws out the idea. Then ina-assess na lang niya kung the variables around will make it work or not.
Following up the question, ano, and then my next question is innovation and sustainability. What's your take on innovation and at the same time, hindi na pwedeng innovate na innovate, hindi naman ma-sustain. So this is a tricky balance between innovation and sustainability. And kayo, what do you, ma'am, sayo, in your case, no, you've innovated along. But at, what do you do to make sure that the business models you have, because businesses can come and go, eh, di ba? I mean, when people ask, today I ask people if they remember what EasyCall was, parang ano yun, and stuff like that, or Telegraph, sige, para just like RT. Ikaw naman nagpupita RT, eh, no? No, stuff like that, pero di ba, they change. So, how do you sustain that model? In your case, kaya ba't alam mo, magdadala ba ako ng stroller, or, di ba, I just bring him, and stuff like that.
Balik ko sa akin po, so, tinitingnan ko rin po yung need ng market, again, no, external assessment, so, ganun po, no? So, ngayon, nakita ko po, like, for example, nauso po yung mga pets, yung marami po sa atin ngayon na may mga dogs po sila.
And the most are allowing na.
Tapos wala pa rin po akong nakikita ngayon na merong ganun na idea na nag-offer na nagpaparent na pwedeng sakyan po ng mga dogs. Kasi usually yung naging experience ko po ngayon, meron kaming stroller and then gusto po ng mga nag-rent nga na pahiramin yung stroller para isa kayo mga aso nila. So I think that's one dun sa pang-innovate factor na magdagdag ng ganun unit.
Wow.
And then another po, nakita ko rin po yung need ng mga parents na meron po silang mga anak na like two or more. So normally, kapag yung isa lang po yung anak nila, nakakapag-rent po sila ng isang pushcart. So ngayon, kapag dalawa, nakita ko po yung nahihirapan po sila. Kung dalawa yung rent sila, isa lang po yung magsasala. So another way na nakapag-innovate po kami is gumawa po kami ng cart na pwede po yung pangdalawahan.
Wow.
So ganun po siya.
So that's sustainability. Ivy, what's your take on sustainability for businesses? Businesses can come in and go.
Sustainability, yeah. As an entrepreneur, you have to watch out against burning out.
Mm, yeah, that's. Can you speak a little bit about burning out?
Yeah, because as I mentioned, in the first few years, you're really gonna burn that candle, midnight candle. You have to work hard. But then there's a difference. I recommend that you read the book, The E-Myth by Michael Gerber.
Yeah.
And it says there basically that you need to be working on the business and not in the business. So you need, if you are, the test is, can you leave your business, for example, and take a vacation for 2 months? If the answer is no, that means you're not an entrepreneur. That means you're self-employed. Because you can't leave the business. If you leave the business, babagsak yung negosyo. So that means you haven't set up systems. You haven't made the business sustainable. So you need to put in a management team, you need to put in people that you trust, and that's one of the challenges of starting a business, is getting the right people on the bus.
And moving them to the next level.
And being able to stop being a control freak and get out of the business and just let the people run the business, and that's how you make it sustainable.
Sir Mon, you've been exposed to the bigger companies.
Yeah.
How about, you know, the
exactly.
Control issue?
Exactly,
control
issue. Sustainability issue, Artie's right. It's easy to start a business, but yun nga, working on that business, when you say on the business, sure, kinitingnan natin yung negosyo in the realm of yung variables natin, yung competitive environment. Sino ba ang mga competition ko dito? Yung competition natin, alam niyo, hindi lang yung mga magawa ng same products na ginagawa natin. It could be a new, totally new product. Example, naalala nyo yung mga video rental, or yung, until now, meron pang mga video CD for sale or rental. Alam niyo sa States, or even dito na, nakikita natin, lumina na yung negosyo na yon. The business model nagpalit na. Kasi anong nagpalit sa kanila? Bakit lumina sila? Kasi yung music, downloadable, It's a new industry. Yun na yung kalaban nila actually. It's not the other video rental stores, but you know, you have to look at potential threats also. Doon sa negosyo natin, hindi yung tatin lang, but yung negosyo as in general, that particular industry. Ang kalaban natin may not be the current competitor in that same product or service. It could be another, a totally different product. So, tingnan nyo. Ang kumalaban na, since the download na because of Steve Jobs and other innovators, na nada-download ng music, may YouTube, you can easily watch on demand all this video and music and whatever, talagang naging less na yung need dito sa mga rentals. So that's just one example. At marami pang iba. In the bigger corporation setup, which I'm a part of also, that's my other hand. For example, in Selecta, you've heard of Selecta, I suppose, ice cream. And gumagamit pa kayo Selecta? Yeah. Parang hindi kayo masalala. I just about to say that ice cream has been, it's a heritage brand, started 1948, but RFM, which a group I'm part of, bought that brand. Mula noon, parang continuous yung innovation. Just to tell you na ang innovation hindi lang sa SME. The bigger the company, the more you need continuous innovation. Hindi pwedeng mabuhay ang kumpanya if you produce the same product over and over again. Even Coca-Cola with its very good Coca-Cola products, that's stable yan. Parating meron silang mga packets of innovation and innovative products along the way. It could be a diet, Coke Zero, or Sprite, and other flavors soda that there is. In Selecta, ganun din ginawa. Hindi na puro ice cream na yung pang-inis ko. Parang dumakas yung market, dahil medyo market leader na po ang Selecta, 80% of the market. So parang, to grow that business, it's not really to kill really the remaining 20% competition. To grow the business is to grow the market. Yun ang kailangan. How do you grow the market? Eh kung ang Pilipino daw, 2 times a year lang kumain ng ice cream. Alam niyo yun? In general, maybe not you guys here, but pag in-average mo, divided by the population, and definitely not Randall, no, twice a day daw. So, twice a year.